Hello and welcome to week 52, an entire year of digital Zentangle. So thanks for joining me for the entire year. If you have, you should get a gold star for attendance. Anyway, we are going to start today with some doodling. I'm not going to do any patterns. So just draw a circle, a good size circle someplace. Put a dot in the center and you're going to divide it into six sections. So I go straight across and then I make a skinny X, so kind of mark your little spots there. And then make a skinny X that goes through the center line, or divide it into six, however you want. You could do eight if that's easier, so you just do an X and a plus. So you don't have to have six, you can do eight. And then over a little bit, you're gonna do the same thing. Draw another dot there, and do the skinny X and the line through, or if you're gonna do the plus or the X, whatever you wanna do. All right, so we're gonna draw a bicycle. So I'm gonna switch over to my chubby marker here. And from this little center point here, I'm gonna draw up at a sort of an angle. I'm gonna draw the bike stand, or the seat stand, excuse me. And then from this point here, I'm gonna draw a taller one that's angled in also just a little bit. So it's gonna be a little bit taller than the other one. And now I'm gonna go back to the first one and draw a line that comes down, not all the way, but comes down, and then a line at the bottom for the pedal. And then from here, you kinda wanna angle it up a little bit. This is the crossbar that keeps it all together. Of course, this is not anatomically correct for a bicycle, but it's just kind of a cute little sketchy one. We'll put some handlebars on here. It's kind of an open V or a boomerang shape. And of course, you can get way more detailed than this if you'd like. You can certainly add a lot more details to that. So I'm going to put the chain on here now. So you wrap it around the back axle and it just crosses over the front of that. I like to put a little dot there so it looks like it's holding on to something. And then I'm going to go around the wheels and put my wheels on, my tires on. So you can make these a little bit thicker. Of course, you could use colored markers if you wish to have a colored bike. You could do that, or you could just leave it black. So something just like that. It's a cute little quick sketchy type thing. If you want, you can add a basket to the front. Kind of comes out straight, a little bit of an arch, a smaller section, and then kind of angles back a little bit, something like that. You could do like a basket weaving type of pattern. I'm just gonna do a checkerboard type of thing. You could put a big flower on the front. You could put fringe on the handlebars if you want to. I'm gonna put some flowers in my basket here, but I'm gonna switch back to my skinny pen. I'll draw the little, I'll just draw the little tissue paper up in here first. So this is kind of like the wrap. Imagine I've just come from the farmer's market and they've wrapped it in some beautiful paper. So you can draw your flowers in there however you want. The one that we did in another previous class is just kind of a swirl on the top like that. And then it comes down into like a rose shape. So you could do a whole bunch of those, skinny, small, tall, whatever you want. Just kind of get that basket or that paper filled with different roses or different daisies or whatever it is easy for you to draw. If you don't like to draw flowers, you certainly could draw a little cat or a little dog or even a little person sitting in this basket, even though I wouldn't recommend riding your bike with a person in the basket, but you could do it if you want, just for a picture. Just like that. So you could draw other kinds of flowers. Maybe just a little circle with kind of like some wonky daisy flowers here. You could add more to it and make your own flowers, kind of make it. If you make the flowers a little bit more oval or oblong shaped, it's gonna give you the dimension that it's kind of laying sideways. So I think that will work. So we'll get started with our next doodle. So I'm kind of thinking spring stuff. It's kind of wet outside, so we're gonna draw some fungi. So I'm gonna start with my little toadstool bottom. It's kind of bulbous at the bottom, but flat. And then one side is a little higher than the other. Draw kind of an arched line above. Come down just a smidge, and you're gonna draw an oval that goes like that, kind of like it's wearing a little hat. So right underneath the bottom section, you're gonna double up that line. They don't touch, of course. And then when you get to the top, you're going to kind of go wide, and then this is where you're going to make your toadstool shape. So it kind of comes to a little bit of a rounded point there. You could add any kind of design to this that you want. You could do with the classic red and white dot that, you know, I don't even know if these mushrooms must exist somewhere, but I've never seen one. So underneath, you can draw the fins, or I call them the fins, I don't know what they're actually called. They kind of radiate out from the center. So as they get out closer to the edge of the, away from the center stem, they get a little bit wider, because that's going to give you the illusion that it's going to be a little bit more three-dimensional. Turn my paper back here and draw the other side. So they see how they get a little bit wider as you go out to the outside edge. That's the kind of look that you want. And then these other ones behind just kind of fill in. So you can draw a whole bunch of these together. You can draw different sizes, different types of mushrooms, whatever it is. I'm just going to draw one more cute little one here. You can have them as a border between something if you want to use it on a Zentangle design that you're doing. You could kind of pop one in just for fun and do your Zentangle around it. You could do a whole section of them to kind of split up other Zentangles. Or you could just make giant mushrooms and Zentangle the actual mushroom itself. So that could be kind of fun. You could do a different patterns inside each of these circles or do something different on the top and the stem. It's entirely up to you how you want to use it. So this is a good place to practice drawing what I call the sketch grass or the quick grass. You kind of draw just really, really fast little movements with your hand. Just kind of random pieces. Put a little piece up here. Just kind of do your baseline and then just quickly throw out some grass pieces. Doesn't even matter if they go the same direction. You just kind of want to have some sketchy grass. It's a good place to practice that if you wish to. So we're going to go to our last doodle. And I think I'm going to start down in this bottom section. I'm going to draw a chicken coop. So I'm going to draw, this is optional, of course. You can draw whatever you like. I'm going to draw a three-dimensional chicken coop here. Put my roof on. Three dimensions are a little bit hard to, or isometric drawings. This is kind of an isometric drawing where it goes back towards a certain point that you can't see off the paper. It's a little bit tricky to draw those if you've never drawn one, so just do your best. And then I'm going to draw my door on here. And I think I'm going to do, I'll just do my chicken walkway, the gangplank or whatever you call that. Put some little pieces on here so the chickens can climb up. Little step pieces. And then I'm going to draw mine on stilts. Again, this is completely optional because this is what's going to make it not look like a doghouse. I'm going to put some posts on the back, on all the corners. And again, those are three-dimensional looking. So if you don't know how to do that, just do your best. Maybe fill in my door here so it looks like it's dark inside. Good place to lay eggs. Something like that. So now I'm going to draw chickens. These are some funny chickens I saw someplace, or birds, they're not just chickens, but you kind of draw a little bit arched line going up, and then you draw this bulbous type of loop. So it kind of looks like an evil eye, and the beak comes right off the top point and just comes back. You draw an eye there and some little tail feathers. And the tail feathers you can have a lot of fun with. You can have big floppy tail feathers, you can have little lines, you can have something really fancy like pheasant tail feathers. You can go completely crazy with these tail feathers. And then do whatever you'd like for the wings. So you can have little loops like that. These guys can be wearing bow ties or hats. I think I'll draw a chicken here. So that one there is just a hen or some other kind of bird that's visiting for the day. I'll draw mine the other direction. I'm going to put some little loopier tail feathers on this guy. And then the comb at the top. So this is my rooster. I guess it would be a rooster. I guess I would need a little bit bigger tail feathers, but that's okay. I'll draw my little feet. And of course you can draw the feet however you want. You could do big duck feet or whatever. Maybe I'll try a duck next. So you can have you can actually Zentangle the birds themselves. And just do kind of a blank wing. Or you can do, you know, Zentangle the wing itself. So let's try a bird, a duck up here. So I'm going to make him a little bit bigger, kind of rounded head and a big body. And then the nose, well, that looks a little bit more like a toucan to me. So we're going to draw a toucan who's visiting from the tropical areas of the world. Don't know what toucan's feet look like, but probably the similar kind of thing. And draw them down a little bit. I don't actually know the anatomy of a toucan, so I'm just going to make it whatever I want. So you can have a lot of fun with these birds. You can draw really big ones. You can draw really little ones. You can use this as a fill if you want for a pattern section. So you could just draw a whole bunch of birds that are going in different directions, all different sizes and shapes and different anatomy and feathers and all sorts of fun stuff inside of a section. So you certainly can use this for a fill if you wish, or they're really, really cute for, you know, birthday cards or little gift tags. You could certainly draw any of that. On here, I'll draw one little teeny tiny guy just for fun. They're really, really cute, so I can't stop drawing them. And then maybe I'll draw a little chick. Let's see, where should I put him? I'll put him over here by the dead. So this will be just a little chick. So you can draw them really tiny. So if you have, those stick people, bumper stickers that people have, you could draw this kind of a chicken family if you want. So you can have little people, you can have a big dad, you could have a mom or whatever else. Put some little feed down here, something to that effect. So these are really, really cute. Of course, you can use color. You can make them entirely your own. You can add some designs to your chicken coop or make it really fancy. You could draw a big castle or something like that and have a lot of fun with it. I hope that you enjoyed the doodles for today. I know it's not really technically patterns, but sometimes it's fun just to learn how to doodle some random things. So I do hope that you enjoyed these springy type doodles, I guess. And I hope that I will see you again virtually next week as well. Have a great week. Thanks for joining me.